Hi, everyone. My name's Tim Brawn, and I'm a postdoc in Matt Wilson's lab at the Picower Institute for Learning and Memory. Today, I'm going to tell you about some of the work we do, so let's head on up to the lab and check it out. The Wilson Lab is a behavioral, computational, and systems neuroscience lab focused on the role of the hippocampus in learning and memory. The hippocampus is a brain structure that helps form new memories and make them permanent. It's especially important for spatial memory. The hippocampus contains neurons called place cells. Each place cell tends to become active in a specific location. For example, the central figure here depicts a rat exploring a rectangular arena. Five place cells are shown, and each place cell fires at a different location in the arena. Thus, an ensemble of place cells will fire in sequence when a rat runs along a path, as shown in the figure on the right. Each color here represents a different place cell. As the rat runs down the track, the place cells will tend to fire in sequence, with the purple place cell firing at the beginning of the track, followed by the yellow place cell, and so on. In people, the hippocampus is necessary for episodic memories. Episodic memories contain what the experience was, when it happened, and where it was. The hippocampus receives all the information from our senses and all the emotional information about how we felt and binds it together as a memory. Let's go into my experimental space to see how we study the hippocampus and how it interacts with other brain circuits. Here we have my computer workstation, where I write code for the experiments, run the experiments, and analyze data. A recording box where brain recordings can be made during rest or sleep, a few apparatuses I've built for testing behavior, and a workbench for constructing electronics and other components. In one project, I wanted to study how rats can learn the location of food based on sound cues. To do this, I designed and built an automated maze in the shape of a plus sign, a syringe pump which dispensed a liquid food reward, and a response port module which controlled the syringe pump, as well as infrared sensors that monitored the rat's responses, were located at the end of each arm. The rat initiates a trial by probing the port lit by a green light. That produces a sound, which indicates where the reward will be. If the rat makes the correct choice, it gets food from a syringe pump, and the sound plays again to reinforce the association. Here, a rat shows it has learned the association between two sounds and two reward locations. To study the relationship between brain activity and behavior, we use tetrodes to record the electrical signals from neurons. Tetrodes are electrodes with four channels that can simultaneously record from many different neurons by comparing the electrical activity across the four channels. We make tetrodes in the lab workshop with our tetrode twister, which was designed and built by Wilson Lab postdoc John Newman and postdoc Jacob Voigts from the Harnett Lab. Tetrodes are made by twisting four electrode wires around each other, fusing them together with a heat gun, and cutting them down to size. The tetrodes are then loaded into a microdrive. The microdrives currently used by the lab were designed by Jacob Voigts and John Newman, along with Matt Wilson and Mark Harnett. These microdrives can fit up to 64 tetrodes, or 256 channels of electrical activity, and each tetrode can be independently moved up and down within the brain. In this experiment by former lab members Thomas Davidson and Fabian Klusterman, hippocampal place cells were recorded as the rat traversed a winding track. In the top left figure, you can see seven color-coded place cells. The individual dots represent each time a place cell fired during one lap on the track. The bottom left figure presents the same information, but in real time as the rat runs along the track. The video shows the rat running on the track. It also shows where he was located as each of the place cells fired. The popping sound is the sound of those place cells firing. At this early part in the track, you see a cluster of green cells at the very beginning, followed by lighter blue cells, and then a darker blue cell around the first bend. By the end, you can see how the place cells are distributed across the track. Some cells, like the yellow cell in the top right corner, are very spatially precise and fire only when the rat is in that location. Other cells, like the orange cell, fire in clusters at a few locations on the track. The blue cells are less spatially precise, but still don't fire at every location. The place cells allow us to decode the rat's location from brain activity. In this video, blue arrows predict where the rat is located based only on the place cell activity. The predicted locations of the blue arrows are almost perfectly aligned with the rat's actual position. So, if the lights were turned off and we couldn't see him, we would still be able to figure out the rat's location by reading his brain activity. When the rat stops on the track, you begin to see bursts of place cell activity, including different colored place cells that don't represent the current location. But if you look at the predicted location of that activity, you find that the hippocampus is replaying place cell sequences from other parts of the track, as if the rat is thinking about those locations. These sequences are replayed much faster than the rat's running speed, and they are observed in both the forward and reverse directions, with the blue arrows depicting forward replay and the red arrows depicting reverse replay. This replay activity also happens when the rat is asleep, as if he were dreaming about the track. Sleep is beneficial to memory, and sleep-dependent replay is thought to be a fundamental way the brain makes memory stronger during sleep. The Wilson Lab also records brain activity in mice. In this work by Wilson Lab postdoc Pedro Feliciano Ramos, a mouse is performing a spatial memory task on an H-shaped maze. The different mazes we use allow us to examine memory in different ways. Wilson Lab postdoc John Newman and Harnett Lab postdoc Jacob Boitz have been instrumental in the development of open-source electrophysiology tools. Their next-generation electrophysiology acquisition system, which they designed with help from Wilson Lab postdoc Jack Zhang, has advanced recording technologies while making them vastly cheaper and more accessible for all neuroscientists. These recording advances are enabling innovative experimental approaches. Nearly all the work on spatial memory and navigation has taken place on one-dimensional tracks or two-dimensional arenas. In contrast, this experiment by John Newman and Jacob Voigts, which takes advantage of their open EFIS work, examines how the brain processes space in a three-dimensional environment. The Wilson Lab has more recently been using calcium imaging to study the hippocampus. In this experiment by postdoc Jack Zhang, the video on the right shows a mouse exploring an arena, while the video on the left shows hippocampal activity. The bright spots that come and go reflect changes in calcium in hippocampal neurons as the mouse explores the space. Calcium imaging allows us to monitor large numbers of neurons at the same time. This means we can watch as groups of neurons interact to form memories. After the experiments are completed, the long process of making sense of all the data begins. The complicated datasets we collect require complex computational analyses to understand them. We can also develop mathematical models that simulate the brain, allowing us to generate new hypotheses, ultimately leading to a new round of experiments that will continue to advance our scientific knowledge.
I hope you enjoyed hearing about some of the work we do in the Wilson Lab, and thank you all for supporting the incredible work done by so many people here at MIT.